From the previous videos, you should have grasped a bit about homeostasis, which is how our body maintains the stability of the internal environment in spite of changes from the outside or inside of our body. For example, when we drink an absurd amount of water after a long and stressful marathon, the amount of water inside our body remains aligned with the osmotic concentration in the blood. Now, how does the body accomplish that? First, to be able to respond to a change or stimulus, the stimulus itself needs to be detected by utilizing various receptors inside the body. Once a stimulus is detected, the receptors send signals requesting the coordination center or the nervous system to process the information and orders the diverse effectors throughout the body to return the body to its optimal environment. These steps are called the feedback loops. To understand better about the homeostasis mechanism, let's take a look at the regulation of blood glucose level. The stimulus or disruption to the internal condition can come from the external environment, such as when a person consumes foods or drinks that are plentiful in sugar. After digestion by the digestive system, by which the sugar molecules are broken down into glucose, they start to flood the blood. The heightened blood glucose level alerts the alpha and beta cells in the pancreas, along with the glucose-sensitive neurons in the various parts of the brain, liver, and other tissues, which act as the glucose receptors or sensors. They send signals to the brain, specifically the hypothalamus area. As the blood glucose becomes too high, the brain sends a message to beta cells of the pancreas as the effector to secrete insulin hormones that act on bodily cells so they can take in more glucose. Insulin also signals the liver and skeletal muscles to increase their intake of glucose and store it as glycogen, ready to be used later. If the glucose storage is full, which is 15 grams per kilogram of body mass, the body will store the glucose as fat instead. These actions prevent the blood glucose from staying high for too long, which could lead to serious complications. How about the homeostasis mechanism due to internal stimulus? It's when the opposite change occurs. The blood runs out of glucose supply. Here, the same receptors detect the blood glucose level and pass the information to the brain, which then signals the pancreas, in this time the alpha cells as the effector, to secrete the glucagon hormone. The hormones will flow along the blood and act on the liver and skeletal muscles to convert the glycogen back into glucose, raising the blood glucose level to normal. If the glycogen, the glucose storage, depletes as well, then the fat tissue will be used as an energy source. This stimulus happens when a person is doing strenuous physical activities long after his or her last mealtime. The blood glucose level is an example of the negative feedback loop of the control systems, where the body responds to change by restoring the original condition, similar to when we train with the punching bag. Another good example is the body temperature regulation. Whether it's the inside heat from an exercise or from a cold storm outside, the thermoreceptors in the skin detect all the temperature changes in the body. When the core temperature shifts beyond the accepted threshold, the negative feedback system will work to return it to normal range by utilizing the blood vessel, sweat gland, and others, so we don't easily get hypothermia in the cold or heat stroke under intense sunlight. We've covered the mechanisms of the body temperature regulation in our other channel. Please watch it. The negative feedback loop is how most of the control systems in our body operate. But do you know that the negative feedback loop can be halted so our body stays in a heated condition? During bacterial infections, the immune cells send signals to the hypothalamus to increase our core body temperature to a certain point. Higher temperature generally helps our immune system to fight the infection by messing up the bacterial metabolism, unless it's an emergency situation. It'll subside once the bacteria has been defeated. In the next video, we will discuss the positive feedback loop. While the negative feedback loop works by returning the body into the initial state from the change, the positive feedback loop works by amplifying the change. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.